So the foundation purpose they have given one Allen bolt and this holder, right? So instead of this Allen, I'm gonna use this hex bolt. Reason is that the location of my fitting is gonna be a little different. As I said, this is the location what I'm going to use, but I'm going to use this bolt from the back side and I'll tie this bolt, and I can tie this bolt with the help of regular open end spanner, since the accessibility of this bolt is not there for the Allen bolt, this type of bolt, because there is a sprocket. Now I'm just checking out whether it is touching the sprocket or not from the back side, but no, it is not. And while installing this, I'm going to use Loctite so the bolt will not come out of this at very high speed. So make sure everything is in perfect condition, otherwise you may damage something. So let's just check out this. It's gonna be something like this way. Let's see. I'll just see if I can use the longer bolt also. Okay. Or else you can use a spring washer or something which will hold up. So the bolt is gonna be from the back side and thread lock is gonna be there, and this is gonna be fitted like this way. Now the, if you look at the direction, is little different, so that I'll bend this plate towards the sprocket, so the direction will be in perfect condition. No pinching, make sure no pinching of pipe is happening, otherwise oil flow will be like in restricted condition, or there will be no oil flow at all. So let's fix up now this one. So this plate, as I said, going to mount from back side. Right now nothing is fixed, so I'm not going to tight the holder. I just want to make sure the direction is perfect for the feeder. So temporary I'll just do the tightening. I'll use the thread lock later on. I'm going to use this spring washer since it's gonna be from the back side. So now I'm accessible to, you know, bolt easily. Little bit of tightening, of course, so it will give me some direction. Now this case, I want to make sure the feeder is going towards the sprocket. That means I'll have to bend the plate like this way. Okay, like this way. See, now the feeder is towards the chain. Should drop on the sprocket kit properly. Just keep it in little slightly in touch condition. It will, whatever the excessive part is going to touch, it will just scrape it, because if you keep it little bit away, then you are not sure whether the lubing is gonna be there or not, right? So just now if you see this. Okay, so this is how we will be fitting this chain loop unit. Now this is the feeder is done. Now I'm sure about the unit, right? I'm sure about the unit. So now we'll just fix up this thing with the help of thread lock. Okay, so I'll just but while tightening also, make sure the feeder is properly fitted. Okay, just remove the cover, I don't need this, and this may become later on dusty or something, or sticky. So remove the, it's a basically safety coat, so remove it, I don't require that. apply some nice layer of thread lock, okay, and then okay, just put the spring washer, the feeder, check the if it is less or wiped out. While fitment, just apply some more. Vibrations are gonna be very high in this bike, so make sure you have tightened it properly. Check the feeder direction again, make sure everything is in control, okay, and then just fix the bolt. Okay, the spring washer will retain the tension on the bolt, so it will not pop out towards the sprocket, and of course we have used the thread lock, so it will not get loose also, because if the bolt comes in between sprocket, then there is a possibility of you may have an accident or something, so be careful with it. Okay, the direction is changed, so we'll just check out again. Okay, this is fine, right? Now we'll have to hold the plate because it's moving up while tightening due to retainer. The spring retainer is basically the spring retainer is rotating the plate, so just hold the plate like this way. Okay, so now this is tight. Let it be dry, just check it again. Okay, let it be dry, so the anabond will cover up everything. Now high time to fix up the feeder is perfectly fitting, and now we'll just use the tag. So this is the tag for the feeder. Don't squeeze the tag too much, otherwise it will close the feeder. In fact, it is very hard, so it won't, but still the oil will not come. I'm using small tag over here. I'll just adjust the height once again. Okay, so as you can see, it's now going to drop. We have to calculate as well, that should be 1 or 2 drop maximum per minute. We are not going to reroot, we have already done the routing. Now we will have to fix up the line, because the routing is like this way. I have taken one side out from this side and one is from inner side, because it should not get sandwiched in between the swing arm, so that also has to be taken care properly. So now we'll fix up the line first. Okay, now just wipe out the area properly, clean it. Reason is that the lugs are based on adhesive or sticking purpose. It has got a dual tip what company has provided, so just clean the area properly. Okay, so we are going to stick this thing one by one on the swing arm. This is what they have given. We will Okay, now what direction this is? If you look at this one, the lugs, basically you have to fit the pipe from the top, not from the bottom. Otherwise, if it breaks something, if this lock or if the tension goes on toss, then the pipe might come out of the unit, lug. So now just keep some slackness over here. If you see, now the instructions are gonna be gone, so it's okay, not an issue. If you can remove the instruction plate, okay, we'll stick it somewhere else. Okay, so we'll do the sticking of this instruction plate later on. Or we can stick it in our user manual, since it is now. Just wipe out again. Okay, so we'll fix it up here. One. And the two. So I'm going to, oh yes, perfect. Don't do it from inside, I would suggest that, just in case if it breaks, then you are in trouble. Don't do that. So the third one I'm going to stick here, and things has to be accessible even while working on the swing arm. So it has to be, you know, they can remove the, or we should be able to remove the unit, pipeline easily when we are working on the swing arm or something, or any kind of a work. If it is related to rear brake or the chain sprocket kit or something like that. Okay. It's gonna be here. Okay, okay, so 3 points, 1, 2, and 3, some slackness. Bike is gonna be with the client all the time, so there is no problem of if somebody cuts or something like that way. So now the fourth point, I'm just making it here, clean it off properly. You can use the given tissue, but I'm using this cloth right now. I have the cloth, so I'm using the cloth. Now it's gonna be like this, little bit tilt, and then we are done with the, okay, so we have done. Okay, so as you can see, the routing is done. If you feel you want the tag over here, you can use the tag. Two tags you can fix, but be careful, don't make it tight, otherwise the pipe will get pinched, so be careful with it. This is not gonna be inside the swing arm, so all fine. It's not going to touch the swing arm as well, so that is what we are making sure. If it is so, then you can just stretch little bit or just tag it like this way, so it will not move. We'll just check, nothing is there as such, and you are accessible to this foundation as well, so if somebody wants to remove the foundation, there is no problem. We might use the tag, we have the tag. Now high time to fix up the unit. We are going to fix up the unit in this